challenge is cultural challenges. To be in a culture where it's unreal to go into politics. That's why we have to redefine the word politics by make it simple. It's really about women's lives. It's really about women's issues, the problems that women face every day. And the challenge is also because I come from the opposition party, because I have a Western education, and I want to go faster. And that challenge is a personal issue that I have to deal with. And by walking the campaign trail, by doing training myself, working with the women in defining what they want as a message, that is learning while doing politics, I think that is something that I continue to work, that it continue to make me feel politics is for all of us, especially for women. And these challenges will remain with me, with all of us, because we are from a more educated background, and we have to look behind. Are we bringing the women with us? Where are they? Where do they come from? All that space that we have to allow to make open so that everyone is part of the women's movement. And politics, women in politics, cannot go forward unless there is a strong women's movement. Yes, my mother, who had only 3 years of education, but she did all that she could to send me, to send my sister to the best school, which was a French school. My father, who came from a minority background, taught me about social justice. And then and then the genocide in Cambodia. When I had to flee, I went to France, I went to America when I was barely 20 years old. Having to build my life, define my life on my own. There are challenges, there are moments of great difficulties, but at the same time, these challenges are part of the joy, the happiness, the passion for the life that I have, and for always have a open mind. In a way, I have made it, but I made it on my own, but at the same time, taught myself the hard way, therefore never to forget how hard it was, never to forget that the opportunity that I had, I have to give it to the younger generation of today. I'm learning from them too. They inspire me. I watch CNN, I watch ABC, I watch BBC, and I say, wow, the courage. I think they have to say they own that space. They define that revolution. And for them to stay there, to be even more fearless. But one word is that there has to be unity. There has to be a strong message, and that the challenge of building one voice for that change to happen, but at the same time, thinking about the next step. They are in power now, and that power has to be maintained and sustained. How do we, how do not just the women in Egypt or in the Middle East, but the women all over the world who want change. When we have change, can we maintain that change? That is why we need to be unified. I use it to look at the training program, the different parts of the training program. For example, I say, how do we craft a message? I go into iKNOW politics. It's because different society, different culture define it differently, work toward a message differently. That is very helpful. I use it to see who are the prominent women in other parts of the world. I use it to see what other training exists in other parts of the world. I use it to say, where is the funding? I use it to think about who, especially at the grassroots level, how do they deal with violence in South America? Look at African violence against women. Why is it stuck there? But with a program like iKNOW Politics, there are always solutions. And it's just a click of the finger. You can go into the internet, the website, there it is. The principles will never change. Why I got into politics. The style, yes, because I'm much older, I have gray hair. And the gray hair really is an asset, because it gives me time to relax, because my body cannot move as fast. And then to think about retirement as well, which then allows me physically to, forces me physically to have younger women around me. And it also changes the way I see someone who could be a competitor. And I say to myself, learn from the competitor. She has some, or he has something to offer. If he's not, or she is not that powerful, why do you think of that person as a competitor? There must be something that you can learn from that person.
Mm-hmm.
I think they first have to believe that space is their space. There are always issues of each generation. And for the youth, together, say these are our issues. We make that agenda very clear. But at the same time, don't antagonize other groups, because you are one of the groups. You may look at, we all have the same issue. Reproductive health, unemployment, violence, education. We all have the same problems. But yes, there is that generational difference. Define it so that other groups understand that we are 17 years old, we're 18, we're 21, and this is our problems, these are our solutions. But at the same time, listen to what the indigenous women have to say. Listen to women who are uneducated have to say. Women who are much older have to say. Together, we can have a voice, make that voice a political voice, make that agenda a political agenda. Otherwise, we will never be at the decision-making table. They will always look at us as soft issues. Women's issues are not soft issues. Women's issues are political issues. We have the power.